What's up, basketball fans? Balik lagi bareng gue Ricky Padilla dan juga masih ada Adiani part kedua. Biar gak kelamaan guys, nontonnya dibagi dua. Cuman kita udah bahas yang Western Conference. Sekarang ini kita akan masuk ke Eastern Conference. Eastern Conference juga sama ketatnya kayak Western Conference. Ini probably one of the most exciting NBA seasons yang gue kayak bener-bener look forward.
Ever, because semuanya they're getting stronger.
Yeah.
Additions are being flown across the
yeah.
team. Jadi, semuanya perbaikan juga dengan adisi-adisi yang tepat menurut gue karena kayaknya setiap tim GM-nya ngelihat ini progresnya luar biasa dari tim-tim yang bahkan kayak Minnesota Timberwolves, Cleveland Cavaliers in the East yang semakin luar biasa juga. Jadi it's an open season, bahkan push untuk top 4 di East luar biasa sih. Ini yang kita akan ngomongin.
Sekarang ini dan mau ngomongin tentang Cleveland Cavaliers, mereka of course ngambil Donovan Mitchell. Oh my god, that lineup sih gila banget sih. Sekarang Donovan Mitchell sama Darius Garland bisa fokus untuk
offense.
Lalu masih Mobley, Jared Allen sama Ice Okoro bisa defense tuh semua itu. Of course di bench masih ada Caris LeVert, masih ada Kevin Love, Chetty Osman. Are they?
They're legit.
Legit. For an NBA final appearance atau enggak?
I'd like to think so, tapi I think this Donovan Mitchell trade is big. They got a go-to scorer yang udah proven, surrounded by great talent juga, a great coaching staff. They got all the tools, tapi probably lebih masuk akal ya to compete for that top 4 spot in the East. Of course they got I don't know whether the problems in that Boston Celtic organization is going to be a problem for the team, because I don't think so. That's the hump yang harus mereka lewatin, the Boston Celtics, the Miami Heat, although juga PJ Tuckerless, and the Chicago Bulls.
Do you believe in Chicago? Ntar kita bahas deh. Tapi gue mau
ngomong. We never believe in the Chicago Bulls. And the Toronto Raptors.
Tapi gue mau ngomongin dulu, untuk gue, ini saatnya sih Donovan Mitchell mau buktikan kalau he is not a bad leader sih. Karena dia datang dengan stigma,
reputasi
bahwa.
I think you know him well.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Gue
gak gitu suka sih sebenarnya sama leadershipnya dia sih, jujur aja ya. I know he follows me on Instagram, tapi gue akan jujur aja, gue gak gitu suka bagaimana he treats Rudy Gobert. I don't like it. Dia apa yang ngoper-ngoper sampai orang aja di social media harus bikin videonya cari tuh. Wah dia kasih operan ke Rudy Gobert. Jadi gue jujur, I think he'll be more happier, of course,
in this environment.
Yes,
a fresh start juga.
Ini seumurannya dia semua nih pemain
dan
ini.
Dan itu yang gue bilang tadi ya, di Utah mungkin mereka udah stale.
They're
stopping the progress. I don't know why juga. Mungkin ya karena beberapa kali stumble itu dengan roster yang sebenarnya very potential gitu kan. Gets frustrating, and now this environment yang lo bilang tadi, maybe this will suit Donovan Mitchell. And the real him yang kita tunggu-tunggu untuk bisa explode akan muncul di sini.
Dan gue yakin Cleveland langkah jauh sih di Eastern Conference. Gue pretty sure I think they could make it to the Eastern Conference Finals. Dengan walaupun pemainnya masih muda-muda, tapi gue suka ini semua tuh seumuran dan mereka tuh akan prime mentor bareng-bareng. Mereka they gonna be good in the next few years menurut gue.
Good for 5-6 seasons.
Yes.
Dan memang and game-nya buat mereka adalah that championship ring.
Bringing it
back to Cleveland gitu kan.
Without LeBron. Without LeBron.
That is a statement. And it's more of a team kind of thing now for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Tapi ya belum season ini toh.
Belum season. Maybe not. Kan Eastern Conference Finals. Eastern Conference Finals.
They'll go through to the playoffs top 4 and then Conference Finals makes sense. Itu in the mix with the Sixers, Boston Celtics, Heat or the Bulls.
Okay, kita ngomongin Celtics sekarang. Penuh dengan drama, pelatihnya ada skandal. Akhirnya suspend, yang gue masih gak ngerti kenapa disuspend, gak dipecat. Ime Udoka.
If it's against club policy gitu kan, and it's something bad to do. Tapi kan he did a great job sih.
He did. Masuk NBA
if
Finals.
If he separate his personal stuff sama team stuff, it was okay. There's no, nggak ada yang membuat that personal thing kebawa ke permainan tim atau apa. I think mungkin itu yang menjadi pemikiran juga. I don't know, maybe Stevens has a feeling for him juga.
I guess, tapi
kan handpick ya.
Cara handling PR-nya menurut gue agak salah sih. Tapi of course mereka sekarang ada interim coach, I guess, yeah. Joe Mazzulla, yang belum pernah ngelatih sama sekali di NBA, kecuali NBA Summer League. Assistant coach, orang kepercayaannya Brad Stevens. Dia tugasnya berat nih.
Berat.
Berat, pressure-nya berat.
I mean, he knows the day-to-day of the team, how the team works, yes. Which players yang bisa dia hold on to untuk bisa bantu dia juga. Karena kan pasti kan his voice nggak terlalu didengar, yes. Mungkin di awal-awal ini. Itu dia yang menjadi hal yang menarik ya, apakah the team will work as hard?
Untungnya dia di-respect sama Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown juga sih. Itu kalau lu udah pegang dua orang itu,
it's looking potentially good ya for him. Tapi itu dia tadi kayak, the trickiest part is, will all the team, the players, work for him as hard?
Yeah, that's we have to see. Yeah. Karena kan kalau si Ime Udoka tuh keras tuh, suka kayak maki-maki kalau lagi time out sampai pemain pun harus tahan mental gitu. Kalau Joe Mazzulla nih orangnya kelihatannya kayak calm, cool,
lebih tenang.
Gitu. Iya, lebih tenang aja. Gua nggak tahu apakah dia bisa.
So this guy is interim, ya?
Interim.
Just there for like this season.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe we don't know. Tergantung dia sampai.
Tapi mungkin juga Stevens nggak mau merusak apa yang udah.
I guess. Kayak,
it's like a machine for the Celtics, and they know how the coaching staff deals with the players, and the players know how to work with the coaching staff. Jadi kalau ada perubahan major, takutnya akan membawa justru banyak lagi masalah-masalah lain yang muncul.
Tapi off season ini banyak masalah sih. Dari Danilo Gallinari baru diambil ACL. Jaylen Brown, hangout sama Kanye West, sama Kyrie Irving, itu gue nggak tahu tuh ngomongin apa bertiga itu. Ntar tiba-tiba lagi season aneh gitu kan. Terus ya ada skandal ya si Ime Udoka. Kalau gue pilih Boston Celtics, they're not going back to the finals.
Oh iya. Tapi mereka punya Malcolm Brogdon.
Oke, dia got Malcolm Brogdon.
That's the guy yang menurut gue bakal menutupi weakness yang kemarin ada di finals.
I know, just point guard, playmaking,
And he has the IQ, basketball IQ yang bagus juga. Tapi I don't know,
Ada Blake Griffin.
Oh iya, Blake Griffin.
Wah ini silauan nih, bentar guys ya. Harus digelapin dikit nih, kayak gini nih. Tapi gak masalah, oke, okay, it's goyang. No cutting-cutting, kita gak ada edit langsung. Tapi ya ada Blake Griffin. Mungkin Carmelo mungkin sebentar lagi mungkin mau nyusul ke Boston Celtics. Tapi kalau gue sih, dengan ada Joe Mazzulla, I think, I know dia kayak udah di belakang benchnya Celtics, kalau tadi beda, lu kok udah di depan jadi head coach, the pressure, the strategy, the adjustment, so
problem
different.
Solving juga,
problem solving, yeah. Game, rotation.
That's gonna be hard.
Mm-hmm.
But
so I'm not a believer sih.
Yeah, but the bookies are a believer in the Boston Celtics.
Who?
The bookies. That is strange.
But yeah, mereka sayang sih di final kemarin ini Jason Tatum gak bisa perform seperti biasanya.
Yeah, tapi we didn't expect them to do as great as they did.
I guess.
Yeah. In the playoffs, yang dimana two series yang kita lihat potentially they're gonna be knocked out.
Hampir
that Bucks series,
that Heat series, that Jimmy Butler 3, kalau Jimmy Butler 3 poinnya masuk bubar itu udah. But I guess tahun ini mereka tuh masuk ke finals. Mereka gila banget dari ranking paling bawah.
Yeah, itu yang turnaround yang
turnaround itu gila.
Second half of the season.
Yeah.
That's part of Ime.
Ime, Dan gua enggak bisa dapat. Ya itu ada menurut gua udah pakai. Menurut gua mereka bisa masuk ke semifinal aja udah bagus banget sih. Next season sih kalau menurut lu?
I think so too. Tapi I don't know. Maybe the bookies are right. Maybe a lot of people will doubt them.
We have to see.
Yeah, we'll doubt them. The head coach is questionable.
Mungkin orang ngeliatnya sebelah mata mungkin ntar.
Yeah. Dan itu juga yang terjadi di season lalu. Yeah. Kayak, there's a new coach coming in. What can he bring to the Celtics? Loaded starting five-nya. A lot of starters are injured too. I don't know.
You don't know,
but they're gonna make it to the playoffs. They're gonna semifinals should be good. Even the Western the Eastern Conference Finals juga bisa gitu. Depends.
Tapi ada lawannya nih sekarang. The Brooklyn Nets, tim yang tahun lalu di sweep satu-satunya sama mereka. Satu-satunya tim yang kena sweep juga di playoff. KD and Kyrie kayaknya udah balik udah romantis lagi setelah KD ngambek minta dipindahin.
That's strange ya. Itu kayak that's like Kylian Mbappe di PSG gitu kan.
Tapi harus like, minta pindah lagi.
You have a contract, lo udah setuju untuk play di situ. You have to be professional, right? The KD has a 4-year contract.
Yeah,
that's even longer.
Tapi dia suruh pilih, pelatih, manajer atau gue kata gitu kan.
Iya. I think juga dia punya player power yang banyak di Brooklyn kan. Kayak when you sign KD dengan segala macam in his locker dan ya memang he's trying to win gitu kan. I think this is the best environment juga buat dia to win with the Brooklyn right
untuk
now.
Untuk bisa buktiin
the Brooklyn Nets right now. Udah dikelilingi juga oleh pemain-pemain yang sekarang lebih baik dan I think he just has to play basketball, do his thing, and work hard for the.
Bosen dia di rumah suka main-main Twitter, balas-balasin orang gitu. Itu gue nggak ngerti sih. Yeah. Waktu luangnya lumayan banyak sih dia. Makanya bisa minta-minta treat. Kyrie juga, gue jadi Josiah sih, gue pusing sih pala gue sih. Yeah. Pemain gue begitu semua.
Tapi kan itu salah dia juga.
Iya sih.
In the first place.
I guess. Sekarang punya Ben Simmons nih, yang bisa. Siap jadi defender terbaiknya Nets kemarin sih gila sih dia dia jaga Giannis sih kuat banget sih menurut gue sih tapi do you trust this Nets dengan adanya masih Seth Curry, Joe Harris coming back?
I mean itu juga penting ya kayak Seth and Joe going to play for the Nets. They got great solid shooters yang bisa accompany KD. I think those two will complement him kalau KD is fully in to the squad. I think they'll be good.
I think menurut gua gak akan kaget sih kalau Brooklyn dia kan lebih jauh. Dia kan Nick Claxton is up for a breakout season.
Yes, ya itu dengan udah gak adanya DeAndre Jordan, udah gak adanya Drummond.
Yeah.
Step up. He's gonna be the starter. I think he adds a lot more to that team.
NBA fantasy Nick Claxton sih. Nick Claxton perlu sih. Tapi gua yakin kayak tahun ini. KD, Kyrie, I think they're motivated, man. Mereka habis dikena sweep last season di Malo diketawain satu-satunya gitu kan yang kena sweep.
Tapi itu, they were all close games. Yeah. Not that bad sebenarnya. Yeah, just missing that.
Tetap orang akan ingetnya 4-0 itu sih.
Yeah, and they're missing that high level intensity to close games. Itu yang mungkin hilang. Itu juga karena lack of commitment menurut gue sih. Lack of commitment, because kalau kita lihat rosternya, that roster can actually win the title.
They should.
They should, but they're not doing it because that lack of commitment and intensity and all the close games.
I believe this season, I would trust them. So I would trust them to at least make it to the Eastern Conference.
Round.
No, Eastern Conference. What?
Lu dari kemarin bilang conference finals ya?
Iya. Yeah.
Last season you told me that.
I know, last season I know, I didn't kena sweep. Okay, semifinal ya? I think semifinal, I think they could. Tapi mereka lumayan deep, man. Masih ada TJ Warren, pemain barunya. Jadi, they got all shooters though. They got all shooters untuk temenin KD sama Kyrie, but defense ini loh, selain Ben Simmons sama Nick Claxton itu, mereka harus pikirin sih nanti gimana sih. So, for what trust the Nets untuk bisa lebih baik daripada musim lalu kalau lo?
Second round.
Karena kita ngomongin yang Adi kaos yang lagi pake.
Oh
iya.
Yeah.
Tetangganya Nets.
The Knicks.
Are they gonna tank? Tapi gak mungkin lah ya, mereka udah dapat Jalen Brunson. Isaiah Hartenstein. They look really good though in the preseason.
Yeah.
Jalen Brunson sih mainnya jago. And RJ Barrett baru tanda tangan kontrak baru, so Julius Randle I think gonna be better. Mereka punya.
They're riding a lot on RJ.
Yes, akhirnya juga mereka punya point guard beneran nih.
Yeah.
A solid point guard, legit point guard.
Tapi gue masih nggak percaya how bad they were last season.
Gue juga nggak percaya.
Yeah, after a great previous season. It was supposed to be up and nggak sehancur itu gitu. I don't know what went wrong.
It just, I think mereka nggak punya leader sih. Sekarang ini menurut gue dengan hadirnya Jalen Brunson.
Brunson ya.
I think he could be a leader. Dia udah main sama Dallas udah bisa sampai bawa ke Western Conference Finals. So
tapi itu yang menurut gue juga kita ngomong tadi Dallas kan kayak I don't think Dallas misses him too much. Tapi for other teams, he's a great addition.
He is.
Yeah, kan?
Mahal.
Mahal.
Ini mahal gajinya.
Tapi kan itu bukan kali pertama Knicks signing someone expensive, tapi will not do the business juga gitu. Because the pressure beda kalau lo main di Knicks kan. I don't know why, it's just overhyped everything.
But we'll see. I mean like, menurut gua, I think they're going back to the finals.
Huh?
I mean the finals. I'm going back to the playoff. I mean going back.
Gue kaget.
gue ingetnya mungkin tahun 2001 atau berapa?
Gue ingetnya gue pikir tahun 1997
ya, waktu masih ada Allen Houston sama Patrick Ewing ya.
Iya man.
But yeah, I think jangan kaget, gue mereka bisa balik ke seat nomor 5 sih.
Oh iya? Not the play-in even?
Hot takes. Seat nomor 5.
Nomor 5 ya? So top 4, we're talking about Cleveland coming in to be
Milwaukee,
well established di sana gitu kan. So the Knicks are going back to where they belong.
Number 5. Gua tahun lalu kan
better than the Brooklyn Nets.
Salah prediksi Bulls. Siapa tahu gua tahun ini prediksinya salah prediksi Knicks.
Masih ada Toronto Raptors, man. You don't rate that. Wow.
Timnya Adi selalu Toronto Raptors pasti.
Great coach, same as Memphis. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the Memphis Grizzlies.
Oh iya, di West. Iya, kita nggak sempat bahas.
Yeah, belum sempat bahas, because I think they'll make it to the finals.
Itu ntar kita terakhir ngomongin finals.
The Western Conference Finals.
Wow, yeah. Again. Oh, Conference Finals.
Again, it'll be a great matchup between them and
Nuggets.
For me, the Nuggets. Yeah.
Dua tim muda tuh.
So exciting.
Kita belum even bahas Atlanta.
Oh yeah, Atlanta.
Atlanta dapat the Jonte Murray.
Yeah, the perfect balance for Trey.
I think so.
And this is thinking about the future juga. Karena I think the future in the East is the Cleveland Cavaliers and the Atlanta Hawks battle.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, with the roster trying to starting to shape up.
Atlanta tapi gila sih. Karena jadi Trey udah bisa fokus untuk offense. DeJounte defense-nya gila banget.
Defense is unbelievable.
Yeah, and then
what a steal to get him.
DeAndre Hunter I think akan lebih bagus. Of course John Collins and Clint Capella. Mereka bench-nya juga nambah banyak.
Capella, I love, always love Capella.
Yeah man.
Tapi bagaimana project ini bisa ditawarin ke DeJounte is interesting.
Yeah. I mean DeJounte udah gak mau bagian jadi tim tanking. Gila ini 17 menit tong. Serius, gak merasa 17 menit gila ya. Tapi Atlanta, I think even though ada DeJounte, I don't think they can get over the hump.
Over the hump as in what?
As in like masuk balik lagi ke conference finals kayak dulu.
Belum. Yeah.
Cause that was them dua tahun yang lalu.
Yeah. Because itu they don't know what to do with Trey. Belum ada kontra strateginya yang tepat gitu kan. Now they're starting to figure out, teams are starting to figure out how to play with against Trey, dan itu yang mungkin oleh karanya Hawks mikirin nih, how to protect this guy. Okay. How can you progress this game juga gitu kan. That's the answer.
What's the ceiling for the Hawks?
I mean for now making the second round is just good for now. For next season, now we're talking about them coming back to the finals, conference finals.
I like that. Mm-hmm. I like that.
Next season is about the Cavaliers and the Hawks in the East for me.
Next season, eh?
Next season.
This season, yeah. Next season.
Young, exciting. The coaches are ready.
Berarti ini tahun terakhirnya tim tua nih.
Yeah, tim tua udah.
Tim tua.
And I think the fans juga udah mulai starting to get tired with the vets.
Berarti kita ngomongin Milwaukee, Nets, Philly, Miami, 4 tim ini nih, ada yang gue miss kayaknya kira-kira, tapi enggak sih, 4 tim ini nih favorit untuk bisa lolos ke NBA Finals dari Eastern Conference this season.
Yeah. Milwaukee tapi kan itu tadi
Giannis
is a great player, yeah he is, he's a beast, monster, whatever you want to call it. But the Bucks without Chris Middleton is a different Bucks.
Yeah, without Middleton and without Marcus Bolden di Wave sih.
But I think Chris Middleton is the key for that team. If he's hurt again, it's problems for them.
Not Brooke Lopez. Huh? Not Brooke Lopez.
No.
Tapi Milwaukee gue nggak gitu suka depth-nya. Menurut gue mereka nggak.
Yeah, they're not that good enough. Yeah, even kalau lo bandingin sama Bulls, yeah.
When your backup center is Ibaka,
who seldomly plays.
Yeah, dia biasa bikin skincare muka, cara treatment muka
halnya. Avec classe.
Tapi gue, yeah, I think ini tahun-tahun terakhirnya menurut gue untuk Bucks, Nets, Heat, and Philly.
Abis itu mereka rebuild ya.
I think nih tahun ini feeling gue Philly loh. Ada masuk PJ Tucker.
Iya, yeah, PJ Tucker is a great addition. Itu yang
tapi pelatihnya aja sih.
Pelatihnya
selalu. Tapi gue percaya Harden, he will be so much better.
Better, now he's better, yeah. Embiid, udah cukup lah dia untuk jadi apa tuh kalau dibilang
MVP tuh marah pasti nggak jadi MVP.
Orang-orang bilangnya kan apa bridesmaid, ya kan? Always second.
Yeah.
Now dia punya kesempatan untuk jadi MVP kan.
So actually that's my pick untuk Eastern Conference tahun ini, Philly sih.
To go to the finals.
Oh yeah, Philly. I don't know why I picked that.
Yeah. Yeah, I picked them last season.
Yeah, I picked them this season. Lo pikir kalau dari East siapa yang keluar?
Yeah, if everything goes well, I don't know what the coach should be. Yeah, I think Boston Celtics. Yeah, I don't believe them last season, but I do believe them strangely with all that's happening.
Okay, 20 menit. Gua lagi ngeliatin.
With all the things that are happening in the team, tapi I think the players are focused. No matter who's at the helm, I think they'll just make it to the finals.
The Celtics go Philly.
Yeah.
Okay. Gua, I don't know why I feel. Gua sih takut. Gua sih hot takes banget sih. Tapi oke, okay, Eastern Conference kira-kira seperti itulah, kita nggak bisa terlalu bahas terlalu banyak karena 20 menit. Jadi kita sebelum ngomongin.
Kita belum bahas Bulls, man.
Belum bahas Bulls sih. Bulls gimana Bulls?
Bulls juga kan kalau misalnya last season nggak ada cedera, I think Zach LaVine
juga. Zach LaVine. Lonzo.
Bisa.
Lonzo lebih, still out.
Yeah. Tapi record mereka bisa lebih bagus gitu.
Gua nggak percaya sih yang.
Tapi we never believe in the Bulls.
Iya. Yeah. Gua percaya tahun lalu tapi tahun ini gua udah nggak percaya sih.
Iya, yeah, gua udah nggak pernah percaya.
Iya, yeah, Lonzo. Aduh, yeah. Cedera. I think, yeah, DeMar. I think that's the ceiling though, untuk DeMar and the Bulls and Zach LaVine. They don't have the role players. I know Drummond might be going crazy.
Yeah.
Drummond kayak apa? Gila, precision tuh jauh banget.
Gila banget.
3 point karena bisa 3 point karena. Gokil sih.
Itu udah ada sih di senjatanya dia, cuman sekarang lebih keluar lagi.
Iya. Yeah. Dulu video terus tuh. Summer off season 3 point cuma akhirnya kadang boleh kayaknya mungkin dikasih sama Billy Donovan sekarang kayak bebas lah lu mau 3 point.
Tapi ya kembali Bulls is Bulls, Billy Donovan pula kan.
It's the key is Patrick Williams.
Yeah.
Baby Kawhi. Gua call him Baby Kawhi. Katanya tambah tinggi malah sekarang. Patrick Williams kalau dia bisa benar-benar explode. Okay, Bulls got a chance. Bulls got a chance. They still got Alex Caruso.
Caruso.
Yeah. Eh, siapa lagi pemain Bulls ya?
They got Dragic?
Iya, yeah, they got Dragic. But he's not gonna do anything.
Nah.
They got Javante Green. Damn.
So just Dre?
Ya, yeah, Dre. Gue coba lihat dulu rosternya si Chicago Bulls. Gue kalau nonton NBA ini kadang-kadang gak hafal pemain-pemain yang jujur aja sih. So, but, yeah, DeMar, I don't know.
Ya, yeah, gue sih selalu kan I rate the Raptors more.
Iya, yeah. DeMar susah, man. Tahun lalu kita bisa inget dia kayak 30 I mean, poin berapa kali gitu tuh.
The Raptors now.
What?
The Raptors. What do you think about that?
I mean OG and Scottie Barnes.
That's a very good building block for a team. Yang punya coach juga luar biasa. Van Fleet. Pascal.
Oh, they got Fuch. Kita sampai lupa sama Fuch.
Oh yeah.
They got Fuch and Kobe White. Ayo, they got Ayo. Gila, gua sampai lupa sama Ayo. But the Bulls, I mean like, oh my god, I cannot. Gua gak bisa trust mereka sih.
They're outside the top 4. I think the Raptors has a shout for that fifth spot. Kalau lo tadi bilang apa tadi? Fifth spot for the New York Knicks.
Yeah.
I got the Raptors.
Okay. I mean, they got Pascal.
Yeah,
they got Van Fleet. OG, see? OG. Mm. OG, if you play fantasy NBA, yeah. OG, man. Yeah. OG, watch out for him this season.
So that's why the Raptors will always be in the conversation.
They will always be in the conversation.
And if they make it to the playoffs,
no team
will like to play them.
Yeah, the coach is really good, though.
The coach. Yeah. The
coach is really good.
As with the Memphis Grizzlies, these two franchises.
Yeah.
Well, coach, well drilled, they know what to do. Itulah, yang menurut gue selalu, karena kayak misalnya Bulls, they got a good team, but I don't rate the coach, me personally. But Raptors, they got a good team, solid, and they got a great coach yang bisa ngangkat.
Adi, dengan Raptors-nya dia. Tapi gue percaya sih, Raptors, ya. Yeah.
Every season, they might
go to the playoff.
Yeah, they will go to the playoff. Fifth spot, come on.
Oh shit. Okay, kita sekarang
between
udah.
Between the Knicks and the Raptors, come on.
Iya, yeah, sekarang kita udah tinggal 5, udah tinggal 4 menit lagi nih.
4 minutes left. We're gonna make this a 3-part session.
Yeah, okay. Gua tanya cepet aja, Rookie of the Year. Kita udah selesai lah ngomongin E sama West. Rookie of the Year, Paolo Banchero, Jabari Smith, sayangnya Chet Holmgren cedera.
No, I don't.
Keegan Murray, Benedict Mathurin,
agak Keegan Murray.
Keegan been killing it though.
Yeah, preseason it was so good.
Nembaknya bagus banget sih. Mm. 3 pointnya very poised.
Yeah.
I like him a lot. Yeah. Tapi gua
Banchero. No.
I gotta go with Paolo Banchero.
Yeah.
Paolo Banchero is
because he's from Seattle.
Because he's from Seattle. Karena dia dari Seattle aja sih guys, jujur. Tapi no, I think Paolo Banchero.
He's exciting. Yeah.
Exciting. He's very exciting dan dia mentalnya bagus sih.
Dan he's in a team yang gak ada siapa-siapa.
I mean, ada Franz Wagner. Nanti ada Franz Wagner.
Yeah,
ada Bobo. Yeah.
Tapi dia nggak punya a scorer there.
No, so I think I think he's gonna be the
main guy.
Yes, he's gonna be the main. Gue suka sih, Paolo sih. Paolo aggressive banget sih mainnya sih. So
yeah, with the Duke he was so good dude.
Yeah, so I got him solo.
Keegan Murray.
Keegan will take a lot of shots too sih.
Mm.
Then MVP.
Hmm.
Woo. Gue juga bingung sih MVP sih kalau ditanya gue siapa sih. Gue juga nggak akan.
Jokic,
wow.
Jokic
again?
Yeah, and I think Jokic and Embiid, yeah, both has.
Wow, kayak tahun lalu lagi dong.
Yeah, they got. I mean, tahun lalu I go wild with Dame Lillard.
Oh yeah,
but I mean, wild.
Tapi tahun lalu kan it's either Jokic or Embiid kan. At the end of the day was Jokic or Embiid.
I think Embiid has a lot of proof. He doesn't like being second all the time. And if he goes all the way,
I'll go with Embiid.
Yeah.
So kita agree on Embiid.
Embiid.
No, I'm not gonna tell you. Kawhi Leonard. Kawhi Leonard is gonna be the MVP.
Man, he played ball for like what? 2 seasons.
Yeah, right? 1 season. But
yeah, 1 season.
I think 1 season last year.
Yeah.
It's okay. Kawhi Leonard.
Kawhi.
Okay. 2 menit guys. Okay.
Yeah.
NBA Finals. Siapa lawan siapa? Prediksinya Adiani.
Boston Celtics against the Denver Nuggets.
Ooh.
As much as I want the Memphis Grizzlies to make it, tapi I think Nuggets just has apa tuh? The intangibles.
Intangibles. The tangibles.
What is that?
Bokepnya berat. Bokepnya berat. Oke, gue kalian udah tau lah. Tahunnya Clippers seperti gue bilang, feeling gue
against the Sixers, eh?
Against the Sixers. Dog, storyline-nya bagus.
Yeah.
Storyline-nya bagus. Dog Clippers lawan mantan tim.
Yeah.
Itu bisa dijual.
Yeah. Redemption. Every single season is a redemption season with Dog.
Nggak, cocok di Netflix lagi ada redemption. Nah, lagi ada redemption team. Kalau di Netflix-nya cocok lah.
Dan itu tadi lo belum bilang, who will tank?
Oh, who will tank?
Yeah.
Oh, siapa? Gue yakin Utah Jazz.
Yeah. But
if you are a betting guy,
if I was a betting guy,
bet yang lawannya Utah Jazz.
Yeah. I think Utah and OKC.
Utah OKC Spurs.
Yeah.
I think tiga-tiganya akan rebutan untuk Victor Wembanyama. The best prospect since LeBron James. Gila sih. Jago.
Gila. Then I think Utah all in. Danny Ainge wants that guy.
I think so.
Yeah.
Danny Ainge wants all in banget sih.
Mm.
So, guys, itu two part.
Tapi kita beda ya berarti? Finals?
Finals beda.
Beda ya?
Lu Boston sama
Nuggets.
Gue Clippers sama Sixers. Mm. Kira-kira siapa yang paling salah ntar kita lihat ya.
Yang paling salah.
Yang paling salah, bukan paling yang paling benar. Di, once again, thank you so much, man. Gila, baik banget deh 1 jam. Dia mau meeting abis ini. Udah jam 4 loh, di setengah 5 meetingnya di. Semoga gak telat ya. Adiani, once again, thank you so much for always blessing this channel.
Always, man.
Really appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
And yeah, man, guys, semoga kalian enjoy.
Appreciate you guys.
Yes, appreciate you guys. Semoga kalian enjoy dengan preview kita sih. Selama setiap tahun ya.
Yeah,
so, jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk komen, and we'll see you guys again.
Take it easy, man.
Take it easy, right? Take just it for easy. Fun.
Yeah.
We'll see you guys again next in the playoff. Before the playoff.
Yeah, before the playoff.
Peace out, everybody.